Hey YouTube, today I'm going to show you how to play Stay by Rihanna featuring Mickey Echo, and this is a request. This is just quickly what the song is going to sound like first. Just a little bit of that. A little bit of that song there. Okay, so to play the song, you're going to need the chords C, D minor, A minor, this kind of random ass A minor slash G thing, G, and F. Okay, so if you know how to play those chords, skip ahead, and if you don't, keep watching. So high E string, string 1, low E string, string 6. So first of all, to play C, you put your first finger on the second string, first fret, your middle finger on the fifth string, fourth fret, and your ring finger on the fifth string, third fret. Okay, I'm not really sure what I just said. I think I said that wrong. Anyway, check out the boxes around my head. Hopefully they'll be right. Okay, so the next chord you need is D minor. So you put your first finger on the first string, first fret, your middle finger on the third string, second fret, and your ring finger on the second string, third fret. Okay, so what you do then to play an A minor, all you do is you put your fingers in the shape of a C and just move your ring finger even to the third string, second fret. So you just have C, move your ring finger, voila, A minor. So the chords from the beginning now, you've got C, D, and A minor. Now to play this random ass A minor slash G thing, all you do is you have your fingers in the shape of an A minor, then you just stretch your ring finger and put that on the sixth string, third fret. I think. Hang on a minute. At all. Yeah, that's right. Okay, sorry, it's a really random ass chord. So that's A minor slash G. Then to play a normal G, you put your first finger on the fifth string, second fret, your middle finger on the sixth string, third fret, your ring finger on the second string, third fret, and your little finger on the first string, third fret. Okay, so now there are two ways to play F. There's this full bar F version, or this mini bar F version. So to play full bar F, you bar all the strings at the first fret with your first finger. You put your middle finger on the third string, second fret, your ring finger on the fifth string, third fret, and your little finger on the fourth string, third fret. And then to play mini bar F, you bar the first and second string at the first fret with your first finger. You put your middle finger on the third string, second fret, and your ring finger on the fourth string, third fret. So the difference between full bar F and mini bar F is, for a start, mini bar F is a hell of a lot easier to play, but you get a kind of a more rich sound with full bar F. You can play whichever version of F you want, but if you're a beginner, start with mini bar and then work up to full bar. Okay, so there are a few chord patterns for this song, but it's really cool because basically the strumming pattern for most of this song is just down strums. You just basically do like one down strum on every single beat, and you know, if you're feeling snazzy with the world, chuck in like a few up strums, but I'll show you where you can, you know, get snazzy with the song in a bit. So first of all, I'm just going to show you how to play the intro, which once again sounds like this. Just sped up a bit. What I'm going to do is I'm going to tell you the chord pattern first of all, and then I'll tell you like how many down strums you do on each song and everything. So the chord pattern is, you've got a C, a D minor, then an A minor, an A minor slash G, an A minor, an A minor slash G, and one more A minor, then A minor slash G. So the way this chord pattern fits together is you have two chords together, and the first chord you play for three beats of the bar, and the last chord you play for the last beat. So you have the first chord with three down strums, and then the next chord with one down strum, and then you change, and then you start a whole new bar, and the same thing happens again. So for example, with this, you have C, you have three down strums, then one down strum for the last beat on D minor. Then for the last, well, not gonna lie, for the rest of the intro, you have then three down strums on A minor, then one down strum on A minor slash G. And then that whole A minor slash G thing repeats a further two times. So the whole thing for the intro sounds like this. You have C, 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 D minor, A minor, A minor, A minor, A minor slash G. So that's the whole intro. So that whole chord pattern repeats twice, like I just did, apart from the first time I was kind of chatting over the top of it. So then you get on to the verse, which is where Rihanna starts singing. So the chord pattern for the verse, you basically just play that whole introduction four times. So there's not really much need for me to like talk through that, because you can already do that. So then you get to the pre-chorus, and this is the bit that goes round and around and around and around we go. So what you do is you have four down strums on F. Sorry, so the chord pattern is F, D minor, then A minor, then A minor again. Then you have F, D minor, then G, and G. And you hold each of those chords for four beats, so that means you have one down strum on each beat. So you strum for each time, four times on each chord. So for the pre-chorus you have 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4. Now, not gonna lie, you will probably be getting a bit bored with just down strumming, because I definitely am. So on that pre-chorus, what you can do is at the end of each kind of the last strum, just before you change chord, you can just add like a down up in. So you would have like F, so you have down, 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 up, down, 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 up, down, 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 up, down. So you have three full down strums, and then the fourth, what would be your down strum, you just play a down up instead. And that just kind of varies up and makes it a little bit more interesting for you. So what I'm going to do, I'm just quickly going to play that so far, along with the YouTube video this time, because that's exciting. I might actually, play it this time. Then you get on to the chorus. So the chord pattern for the chorus, you have four beats on each of these chords. So you have C, D minor, A minor, then F. And then that C, D minor, A minor, F, that repeats, and then you just play the intro. So all it is just four down strums on each of those chords, C, D minor, A minor, F. That whole pattern repeats twice, and then you play the intro again. And that's the chorus.
I want you to stay.
Okay, and that goes on. So then you get to the bridge, which, and I can't exactly remember what the words are for that, so I'll just find that. Something about ooh or something or other. Oh yeah, ooh, the reason I hold you. Oh, I'm sorry, not ooh, oh. Anyway, oh, the reason I hold on. So the chord pattern for this is a little bit random, but anyway, so you have, so the chord pattern is F, A minor, D minor, E minor, then F, A minor, D minor. I never showed you how to play E minor. So to play E minor, you put your first finger on the 5th string 2nd fret and your middle finger on the 4th string 2nd fret. That's E minor. Anyway, sorry, so the chord pattern for the bridge, you've got an F, an A minor, a D minor, an E minor, then an F, an A minor, and a D minor. So what you do is you do 4 down strums on the F, 4 down strums on the A minor, then D minor you hold for the D minor you do 6 down strums and then 2 down strums on the E minor. So this is kind of like the thing at the start where you have 3 down strums on one chord and then 1 down strum on another chord. Except with this D minor you have like 4 normal down strums on D minor, then you have another 2 down strums and then another 2 down strums on a different chord. And then you have 4 down strums on the last A minor, four down strums then on the last F, A minor, and D minor. So for that bridge, that sounds like 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4. And then you might have another 4 down strums on that D minor. I'm not really sure, just come listen to the song. So yeah, basically that's the whole song. So yeah, please comment, please rate, please subscribe, please request, please like my Facebook page. My lesson for the day is psychology related, and it's about Piaget's theory of child development. And so Piaget thought that kind of kids like developed cognitively in stages. So like so he kind of thought like, say, well, this is the whole problem. Because his theory was in stages, it meant that you couldn't really ever be like between a stage. You had to either be in one stage of cognitive development or another. But kind of this is now disputed because psychologists nowadays think that kind of cognitive development is just like kind of a gradual curve instead of like step, 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 like Piaget thought. Anyway, you know, form your own opinion, read some textbooks, it's cool. But yeah, so please comment, please rate, please subscribe, and please request.